Myself, Mr. Akshay Kumar Surde, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering. Today, we will discuss about shear force and bending moment diagram. At the end of the session, student will be able to determine and draw shear force and bending moment diagram for a overhang beam, as well as they will determine the position of point of contraflexure. So, draw shear force and bending moment diagram for a overhang beam and indicate the point of contraflexure. So, overhang beam carries UDL 20 kN per meter over a span of 2 meter along with point load at D and C. So, as we know the sign conventions for the shear force and bending moment, if you consider the left side of the section, then all upward forces are considered to be positive and all downward forces are considered to be negative. If you are referring the right side of the section, all upward forces are considered to be negative and all downward forces are considered to be positive. Similarly, for the bending moment, if you consider the section XX and if you are referring the left side of the section, all clockwise movement to the left side and all anti-clockwise movement to the right side are considered to be positive, whereas at the section, if the movement to the left side of the section is in anti-clockwise direction and to the right side of the section is clockwise direction, then the movement are considered to be negative. So, first of all, we will find out the reactions at support A and at B. Therefore, sum of the forces acting in the upward direction is equal to sum of the forces acting in the downward direction. Therefore, reaction at A and reaction at B is acting in the upward direction. So, RA plus RB is equal to sum of the forces acting in the downward direction. So, at D, 40 kN, at C, 20 kN, and UDL of 20 kN per meter spread over distance 2 meter. And therefore, reaction RA plus RB is equal to 100 kN. Now, taking moment about point A. So, we will equate clockwise moment and anti-clockwise moment. Therefore, moment about A, there is a UDL 20 kN per meter spread over distance 2. So, 20 into 2 total load, it will act as a point load at half of 2. So, 2 by 2 plus 40 into 2, this moment is also in clockwise direction. And at point C, there is a point load 20 and its distance from point A is 5 meter, is equal to reaction at B acting in anticlockwise direction, so RB into 4. So, by calculating above equation, we will get reaction at B is equal to 55 kN. So, putting this value in the above equation, reaction at A is equal to 45 kN. Therefore, reaction at A, RA, 45 kN and RB, 55 kN. Now, we will calculate the shear forces. So, shear force calculation, just extend the portion of the beam beyond A and beyond C. Consider the section 1-1 just to the left of side A, section 2-2 just to the right side of A. Similarly, section 3-3, section 4-4, section 5-5, 6-6, 7-7 and 8-8. So, when we refer section 1-1 and consider the left side, there is no portion of the beam to the left of 1, 1, therefore shear force at 1, 1 is equal to 0. Similarly, shear force at section 2, 2 referring left side of 2, 2, so shear force at 2, 2 is equal to, there is only reaction Ra acting vertically upward, according to the sign convention it is positive, and therefore shear force at 2, 2 is equal to 45 kilonewton. Similarly, shear force just to the left of D, that is shear force at section 3, 3, which is equal to, there is a reaction Ra acting vertically upward considered to be positive, there is a UDL of 20 kilonewton per meter spread over distance 2 meter, so 20 into 2, this load will act in the downward direction, therefore it is considered to be negative, and therefore shear force at 3, 3 is 5 kilonewton. Similarly, at section 4, 4, shear force at 4, 4, that is equal to, referring left side, Ra acting upward positive, UDL 20 into 2, this total load will act in the downward direction, minus, and at point D, there is a downward load, so it is minus 40. So shear force at 4, 4 is minus 35 kilonewton. Similarly, shear force at 5, 5, as between D and B, there is no load, therefore shear force value will remain constant and diagram will remain horizontal, and therefore shear force at 5, 5 is also equal to minus 35 kilonewton, or you can calculate shear force at 5, 5 referring left side of the section 5, 5. Similarly, shear force at 6, 6 referring left side of the section 6, 6, there is reaction Ra positive, minus 20 into 2 minus 40, and there is a upward reaction at B which is considered to be positive, so plus 55, and therefore shear force at 6, 6 is equal to 20 kilonewton. Similarly, shear force at 7, 7 referring left side, as between B and C there is no load, so shear force value will remain constant, and therefore shear force at 7, 7 is 20 kilonewton. Shear force at section 8, 8, as there is no load to the right side of section 8, 8, so shear force value will 0. Now we will draw shear force diagram. So all positive values are drawn above the baseline and all negative values are drawn below the baseline. So at point A, there is a reaction, so shear force will suddenly increases from 0 to 45 kilonewton. As there is a UDL between A to D, shear force will vary according to the linear law, and shear force at point D is 5 kilonewton. Due to the point load at D, shear force will suddenly drops from 5 to minus 35 by vertical straight line. So minus 35. Between D to B there is no load, so shear force value will remain constant and diagram will remain horizontal. So up to B, shear force value is minus 35. Due to the reaction at B, shear force will suddenly change by vertical straight line from minus 35 to 20. Between B to C, there is no load, so up to C, shear force will remain constant and diagram will remain horizontal. And at C, due to the downward load, shear force will decreases to 0 by vertical straight line. So this is shear force diagram. Now we will discuss about the bending moment. So for calculation of bending moment, we will consider the section between point A to D, so section XX at a distance X from left end, A, and we will calculate the bending moment at this section XX. So bending moment at section XX is equal to RA into its distance from section XX is X, moment is positive, then UDL 20 into its distance from the section is X, so 20 into X, and it will act as a point load at distance X by 2, this moment is negative. Therefore, RA into X minus 10 X square. Therefore, as the distance X varies from 0 to 2, we can calculate the bending moment at point A and D by putting the value X equal to 0, we will get the bending moment at A is equal to 0. When you put X equal to 2, you will get the bending moment at point D, which is equal to 50 kilonewton meter. Similarly, we can calculate the bending moment at point B as well as point C. So bending moment at point B, you can refer the right side of the B and you can calculate the bending moment at B. So bending moment at point B to the right side of B, there is a load of 20 kilonewton and its distance from B is 1 meter. And therefore, bending moment at point B, referring right side of B, 20 into 1, this moment is considered to be negative. And therefore, bending moment to the right side of B is minus 20 kilonewton meter. Bending moment at point C, as there is a load acting at point C in the downward direction, but its distance from that point is equal to 0. And therefore, bending moment at point C is 0. Now, we will draw the bending moment diagram. At A, bending moment is 0. At D, the bending moment is 50 kilonewton meter, varies according to the parabolic curve. So 50 kilonewton meter. At B, the bending moment is minus 20. So between two point loads, the bending moment varies according to the linear law. And at C, the bending moment is 0. So from minus 20, it goes to 0. Now, think for a while, what is mean by point of contraflexure and how to determine the position of point of contraflexure. So, between point D to B, the bending moment diagram changes its sign from positive to negative. And therefore, the point where bending moment crosses the baseline, that particular point is called as point of contraflexure. So, in order to determine the position of point of contraflexure, we can consider these two similar triangles. And we will consider the position of point of contraflexure at a distance X from end B. And therefore, this particular distance will be 2 minus X. So we will take the ratio of base to height of this particular triangle and the another triangle. Therefore, the ratio will be X upon 20 is equal to 2 minus X upon 50. And therefore, your distance X will be equal to 0.571 meter from end B. Therefore, the position of point of contraflexure from end B, that will be equal to 0.571 meter. The problem is referred from Strength of Materials by SS Bhavikatti, S. Chan Limited. Thank you.